It's Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thanks for checking out my video. Oxalates, oxalic acid. What is this junk? I get lots of questions, as you know. I've received a few of them lately asking me all about oxalic acid. What the hell is this stuff, you know? Does it make you sick? Does it make your hair fall out? What does it do? Well, many foods contain also what we call anti-nutrients, or if you're in America, anti-nutrients, right? And we're talking stuff like phytic acid, we could be talking oxalic acid, we could be talking lectins. So there are different things in foods, because foods are, you know, stuff that contain chemicals in them, good stuff and maybe not so good stuff. It stands to reason that there could be nutrients in these foods that may not be so good for us, after all. So oxalic acid is very common in a lot of vegetables, or we call it oxalate. And it becomes an acid. It actually binds to different things in the body. So calcium oxalates, for example, iron oxalate. So the body will bind. If oxalate comes into the body, what I'm saying is it will bind to different minerals. And this is what we call an anti-nutrient, because it's not so good for us. But when I did research and I looked at the highest oxalate-containing foods, many of them also are very high calcium-containing foods for that reason. So if you eat spinach all the time, like I do, for example. Now, I just received a question saying, don't eat spinach, it's got oxalic acid in it, it's bad. What a load of crap. I eat spinach nearly every day. I haven't grown breasts or, you know, gone retarded yet. And my kidneys are in perfectly good shape. Doctors, urologists, you know, the kidney specialists for a long time told people to avoid oxalic acid with a slightly dodgy kidney. That recommendation no longer rings true. Most urologists now know that oxalate in the diet is only bad if the person's got a dicky kidney or has a really sensitive kidney or a problem in that area. 99.9% of people, in my opinion, who've got reasonably healthy kidneys can definitely withstand oxalates in their diet. Now, I'm not talking about eating 9 pounds of spinach for breakfast and 5 pounds for lunch and then having like 25 pounds for dinner or juicing it and drinking it day and night. When people do dumb things, they get dumb consequences, okay? If you keep hitting your head against a wall, well, it's probably going to bleed after a while. So if you eat way too much oxalate-containing food, and go to Google, chocolate, lots of oxalic acid. There are many different vegetables with oxalic acid in them. So if you're going to eat a huge, hugely rich oxalate diet, you'll probably get a problem. But the same holds true if you eat anything in stupid large amounts. You're going to get problems, okay? I'm talking here common sense. If you're going to eat normal portion of spinach several times a week like me, you ain't going to have problem with oxalates, all right? Especially if you don't eat a high protein diet alongside it. Now, this is the key, okay? High proteins, we know, can create a lot of nitrogen waste, for example, and put a strain on kidney function. Now, if you eat meat several times a day and lots of oxalate foods like, you know, chocolate and spinach, for example, you could well end up with a problem. Especially if you drink several cups of coffee, don't drink water, and have cold beer or wine at night as well. So you're dehydrating yourself with the alcohol, all right? You're not drinking enough water because you're drinking other beverages. You're putting high oxalates in the diet. You're probably going to get a problem. Now, you don't need to be a rocket scientist to work it out. Drinking a few glasses of water a day, I'm not talking 20, I'm talking maybe, you know, several glasses, 2, 3, 4, whatever you fancy. Eating fresh spinach like I do, not a problem. You will not get a problem with calcium in your body. There is so much hype and crap online about anti-nutrients, it makes me sick, absolutely sick. A lot of it's misinformation, where people read something and they immediately jump on the bandwagon, you know. If you knew, for example, how dangerous flying was, all right, long-haul flying. I've got pilots, for example, who've developed tumors from flying in aircraft. Nobody talks about that. But everyone started to talk about the dangers of, you know, radiation exposure when you're 30,000 feet up. If that really got published seriously out there, lots of people would be freaking out about flying. Yet everybody flies, all right? It's all about exposure. It's all about how much you do. If I have a puff on a Cuban cigar, does that mean I'm going to die of lung cancer? Likely not. But if I have that Cuban cigar morning, noon, and night, probably going to get divorced, probably going to get lung cancer, probably going to get sick, all right? But if I have it every now and then, and I do like a little cigar, it's not a problem. Life's here to enjoy, people. It's not to fear. So don't fear oxalates. But if you've got one kidney left, or if you've got a seriously bad blood pressure problem or something like that, you know, you may have some issues you need to discuss with your doctor. But don't just drop oxalate-containing foods because some fool on the internet says that they're not good for your health. If that were the case, you'd never go in the sun, you'd never drink any kind of water unless it was pure, you'd likely eat 1% of foods that you're eating now, and you'll live a miserable life. Life's meant to be fun. Thanks for tuning in.